Okay, so good morning. Very happy to be with you this morning to share some insights about what it means about digital transformation for a company like Total. So as it was mentioned, I've been with Total for 24 years now in various positions, including refining and gas and power. I'm not an IT person, so I don't, as a CDO, I don't develop any kind of shadow IT. And I work hand in hand with my colleague who is a chief information officer. I think it's very important. Okay, so digital transformation starts by people, not by technology. One of my jobs is to make people in Total as happy as people in the on this picture, and also our customers as happy as people in this picture. Digital comes from the outside. It comes due to external progress in internet, telecom, power computation, cloud, etc. But it's all about adopting technology. If you have, you can have the best technology in the world, if people do not want to use them, nothing happens. So it's social, mobile, it's Attawad. Attawad means anytime, anywhere, any device. And key message is that digital transformation is human, cultural, societal, before being technological. There are, in my opinion, two magic words in digital. First one is platform. Platforms have been there for thousands of years. It were markets where people were exchanging goods, but there were hundreds of people exchanging goods in markets for thousands of years now. But now, billions of people can interact on platforms. And one of the key elements is that, in general, these platforms tend to create a kind of monopoly, a natural monopoly. And in internet, winner takes all. And one of the questions I ask myself a lot is, are all these guys friends or foes? How can we interact with these people? How can we partner with them? How can we leverage their platform? Do we have to develop our own platform in some domains? But thinking about platforms of the internet giants is of key importance. So digital, we don't do digital for the sake of doing digital. We do it for business purpose. And digital is two things, basically. It's about creating value out of data, in a broad sense, and transforming the way we work or the way we interact with our customers. Digital, so data and transforming the way we work. And we do it for supporting our strategy. It means improving industrial safety, improving operational performance, reducing our cost, improving our customer journey or employer journey, and creating new businesses. So, an important message: we don't do digital for the sake of doing digital. How we organized in Total? When Patrick Pouyanné asked me to take the job, he told me about breaking the silos. Say, digital is a great opportunity to break silos. So we are not going to have a digital person at ENP, digital person at refining and chemicals, but we are working on transverse domain. Basically, when he gave me the job, he told me, if we develop some kind of digital pumps, for example, I want the same digital pump in refining as in ENP. I don't want to see a digital development for pumps in refining, and so we do it in a large base, which is industry. So the same for marketing, and recently we created a new job for the domain of electricity, because now we are more involved in electricity. And there are these four persons report to me functionally, but they are based in the division, and there are three people reporting to me in my team, which is a person working on digital work practice, another one working on digital innovation, and another one about who is the group data officer. And so I'm going to give you some insight, some focus on all these various domains, and starting by work practice, because as I say, it starts by people. Work practice means improving the way we collaborate and share, improving the way we innovate, and I will focus also on training and acculturation, because I guess I do think it's quite important. So I cannot go through all this this element. However, I'm going to focus on the fact that this year one of our key programs is to roll out Office 365, which is Office 365 by Microsoft. And what is important in this solution is not the fact that it's it puts on it's a more advanced way of using Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. This is not the important point. The important point is they have in this collaborative suite there is Teams, and Teams, which is I would say the kind of counterpart to Slack for those who know Slack. Teams really is able to change the way we work, we interact. It flattens the hierarchy. It's more transparent. Probably there will be less mails because it's about sharing documents, not sending documents. Okay. This is very important, and we put a lot of, so there is a technical project, but also we put a lot of effort in the change management preparing, because using Teams, deploying Teams will have some significant impact on the way we manage people, the way we manage our projects, and the way we interact, including with the outside. I must say that we did a thorough investigation before choosing this suite. We also looked at the competitor, which is Google for Work. It was a tight competition, I must say. All solutions had their merits, but at the end, we made the decision in favor of Microsoft. And what is important as well is that this clearly it's not an IT program. It's something that we work together with the CIO, and that had the COMEX and the CEO were very involved in the decisions. I know some companies where they chose. They say they deployed Office 365 as an IT project, not talking about it to the CEO or talking afterwards. This is not the way to do it, because this is really a transformative project. COMEX and CEO must be very aware of this kind of decision. Innovation, so we have a lot of various tools for interacting with startups to deploy open innovation. Just I will focus on the first one, which is a booster. The booster is we created this place and this team in our headquarters in Paris. So it basically it's a space with 700 square meters where we are able to offer various services. We are able to incubate internal projects, to prototype in a kind of garage, and to do design thinking sessions. We offer all this kind of service, and what is interesting is that now we are able to create other boosters in other places. So there will be a booster this year in Pau, where we have our technical, I would say a lot of technical and research people in Pau for exploration and production. And then there will be other boosters, and it works very, very well. It's kind of, we are, booster is has more demand for services than it can provide. So it's, we are very happy with that. And again, this was something that Patrick Pouyanné asked me very, very early. He said, okay, I want kind of innovation lab or something like that. And at that time, he said, okay, you are going to rent 200 square meters somewhere in Paris. And then you will do this, your innovation lab. And I say, Patrick, with all the respect I owe you, I don't think it's a good idea, because if I put 15 or 20 people in a nice place, in a nice apartment or loft in Paris, the 10,000 people in Paris La Défense will say, okay, what's there for me? So there is some kind of happy few who are selected to do some kind of innovation when costs are reduced. And what's there for the booster is at the heart of, so all our people in La Défense are able to access easily to the booster, and that's why it's successful, in my opinion. Training and acculturation, absolutely key. Because if people are not comfortable, so we have a lot of programs, you know, starting from a digital passport for everybody. We have also reverse mentoring for top executives, very successful program. We have MOOCs. We have made the data science challenges in order to develop the data culture. We make learning expeditions. Many people organize many learning expeditions. It's very good for innovation. We have digital boot camps, but creating, and we have also a program, artificial intelligence for leaders, so that the people think about the artificial intelligence revolution. But clearly, investing in the cultural awareness feel good feeling for leaders about digital is absolutely key. If they are not embarked, if they are not confident, basically we'll do. You will have vision, plan, you will do POC, lot of POCs, but nothing will happen really. So invest in training and acculturation of everybody in the company. Now I move to subsurface, which I would say is a part of the group which is digital native. We have thousands of people there who are who were data scientists before the word data scientists exist. We have hundreds of people familiar with data management. So they are, we have one of the most powerful high-performance computer privately owned. So what is interesting, I would focus on one element, is that we recently announced a partnership with Google for artificial intelligence applied to image processing. Again, it was a tight competition, again with Microsoft, but this time Google made it. And what is interesting, that probably 3 years ago, nobody would have considered seriously to partner with Google. Google was considered as a company for general public, for advertising, but not for professional services. So this is a kind of acceleration. And now we are very excited about what will happen. And this is a true partnership because a team of 10 people from Total will move to the Valley in order to work with 10 people dedicated by Google. And we have a clear roadmap about what we want to achieve both in image processing and semantic analysis. And again, under the impulsion of our CEO, his reasoning was that we invest millions of dollars per year in acquiring geoscience data. So we have a problem which is something which is worth several hundred million dollars. So we can invest. It's reasonable to invest significant amount of money in artificial intelligence in order to solve a mega $100 million problem. For example, in the downstream, it's more difficult to find a problem which is worth hundreds of millions of dollars. So it's easier to start with big problems. Probably we will have some significant returns. Industry, digital for industry. So basically, we have many initiatives. I don't know all of the initiatives which go throughout the group. I monitor carefully, let's say, 10 to 12 programs throughout the group. These are the various elements of our digital industry roadmap, enhanced operator, data-driven asset performance, collaborative environment, and virtual plant, and I will say a word about all of these. Enhanced operator, so it's how the technology can help operator to facilitate their work, to do it more safely, more easily. And at the moment, our key project is Total Industrial Mobility, where we create, where we develop applications which will be available for operators on iPads or whatever. And so there is a very good adoption, and we have several flying teams who go from site to site to deploy this application, and we have a target of 40 sites to be deployed in this year, and probably 30 more next year. And but very important to create the comfort of adoption. You cannot just say this is the application. You need you and because we observe that this refinery do not use the application the same way as this one. It depends on the culture of the site. So you cannot impose things, at least in our company. It depends, it's really cultural. In other companies, maybe it will work differently. So it's the reason why also having a CDO who has been for some time in the company is important, because you have to take into account the culture of the company. So we do also many things with drones, robots. We have a large culture about all this kind of device. We use drones, so various kind of drones. Also, we were able to put drones within our distillation columns in order to make inspection. It's very successful. This is we use a drone made by a startup coming from Switzerland. It's a very interesting drone, because it's a small drone which is in a kind of cage, so it can bump inside without damage inside the column. Data-driven asset performance. So this is another key program. It's all about, let's say, the easy way is, for example, predictive maintenance of rotating equipment. We have hundreds of equipment which are monitored and with this algorithm. I would say that for this subject, we have tens of vendors who say we have the magical solutions. And they all come with slides where their solution is at the heart of our system. And the subject for us is to see how we can keep control of our data. Clearly, there is a big subject there, and how to be able to leverage on the competence of various vendors and keeping control of our data, because many of them they propose solutions which are not too satisfactory. So keeping control of our data is really key. Collaborative environments, smart rooms. So we have probably 20 sites like this, which are equipped with. So the picture doesn't show what really is a smart home. Actually, this one, this was a very interesting project in our subsidiary here in Netherlands, in Den Haag, Total ENP Netherlands, and they did, I would say, an enterprise project around this collaborative room. This is they redesigned their operation. They reshape a space of, let's say, 300 square meter in various modules. For example, one with support to the offshore operation, one for crisis management, one for maintenance, one for production optimization, one for logistics and commercial, because they produce gas and the gas has to be sold on the market in real time. And it's, I would say, an enterprise project. And so they are, these projects are local projects, because you don't do the same collaborative environment in Netherlands or in Angola or in Nigeria. But it's basically they capitalize on digital technology, and these are, I would say, high return projects. And last one for digital industry is a virtual plant. This one is key and probably the most difficult. It's about creating the single source of truth for our industrial installation and managing all data and documents, so creating the 3D models, then making sure that throughout the life of the asset, the digital model remains the same as the physical assets, and giving access to all of this data. So it means that we move from a document-centric approach, where you have a PDF document, to object-centric or tag-centric approach. And this is as well very transformative, because it will have a lot of impact on the way we manage our capital project, the way we manage our operations, the way we interact with our EPC contractors, with our vendors, service providers, etc. This one is really at the heart of digital transformation, because it will be at the heart, and we start with the I would say cold data, the descriptive data of the assets, but at a later stage, the real time data will be as well on this system. So I move to marketing, but I will go faster because I'm running out of time, and I think this conference is less about marketing. So I will just mention, for example, this one, where we work on simplifying the customer experience for payment, which is always a pain point. So we developed what we call the e-wallet, so that people are able either to pay by the Total app, so it's a minimum we can ask. Then people are able to pay through third-party apps, which is more difficult. So Sixt is a rental car, rental car company. And more difficult, the asset itself, the third-party asset itself, will be able to pay. So what we can see on the picture on the bottom right is a car which is owned by DriveNow, which is a rental subsidiary of BMW, and we developed something with DriveNow so that the car is able to pay for the, and this is quite challenging, but this is okay. All what we are working on in terms of simplifying the payment experience. What is interesting to note is that due to digital, we have entered new way of selling our products. We are in the electricity and gas. We sell electricity and gas to end customers that we didn't do before, and we can do that thanks to digital. And we are able now to offer low cost thanks to digital and quality because it's gas and electricity by Total. But what is interesting is that it necessitates new skills. For example, we have some specialists of search engine optimization, and basically you have to play with Google for all of this again with Google, and this is an interesting game because there is nobody of Google in the room. Basically, it's like playing chess with Google, but Google is able to change the rule of the game when you play, so it's a little bit tricky at some time. But this is the customer part of the journey. And basically, that's it. So I hope I was able to give you a global view of what it means about digital transformation for Total. Thank you very much.